First, we'd like to ask you some questions about your activity during the late 1920s and during the 1930s. According to information that we've read, in 1927 you formed the Kokubousha, or the National Defense Society. What was the goal of this organization? And how large was its membership?
その結成の目的はどういうことところにあったのでしょうか。実は当時はこれは日本は今の共産主義者これがだんだん多くなってくる。そして中国とも仲が悪くなってくる。そういうところから、まず自分の家を守るには、これは自分の戸締まりをしなきゃならない。まず戸締まりをすること、そうして外国の来るのを防ぐことで、外国が来た場合にはこれはどうしても向かわなきゃならないんで、それは国防省というんじゃなくて国防者という。で、当時は私は、私の考えは全日本人の国防者であると、こういう考えだから、急速に、同志が増えてきたんです。
数にしてどれくらいだったんでしょうか。
さあ、最初はね、まあ、4、5万だったでしょうね。
Japan at that time was in a situation where the number of Communist Party members was increasing very rapidly. Also, our relationship with China was worsening. And I felt that in order to protect your own castle, in order to protect your home, the first thing you have to do is lock it up tight so that it can prevent from being attacked from outside. And that's the first step in protecting your own country. And if it is attacked by an outside force, of course, we must react to it. And in order to have an organization which can react to such attacks and to protect the Japanese people, I established that organization. And since this was established on the basis of understanding that this is a national defense body for each and every people living in Japan, the membership grew very rapidly. I believe that we started with a membership of about 40,000 to 50,000.
See, were there branches all over Japan?
Yes, that is so.
And what specifically, what kinds of activities did the organization sponsor or engage in?
具体的にはね、これはですね、思想運動をやろうと、こういう考え、それで、本当の純日本主義の思想団体を作ろうというところから出発をしたんで、そういうところから現在においても相入れないのは共産主義と私どもとは相入れない。もうその当時から今日の共産主義というものがあることをですね、予見をしとったから。
And specifically, we carried out various activities, what I might say a thought activities. What we wanted to do was to establish an organization which would promote the pure Japanese philosophy, Japanism as you may call it. And this is the concept on which we started the organization. And from that time, and even today, for that reason,Japanese communism and my organization never meet. From that time, I had forecasted that today's Japanese communism would still exist, and even today, we do not get along.
I see. Were there any connections between your group and groups such as the Imperial Reservist Associations, the Zaino Gunjinkai?
Zaino Gunjinka とか、そういったところとの団体のつながりっていうのはあったんでしょうか。
そういうものありましたよ。
Yes, there were. Yes.
I see. In 1931, I believe you formed the Kokusui Taishuto.
Kokusui Taishuto. Mm.
Why did you form this organization, and who were the founders with you?
それは当時今言ったように思想的にだんだん悪くなる外国からの圧力がだんだん増えてくるそういうところからですね、私が永久戦犯で入った時も尋ねられたんだが、右翼か左翼かというから右翼でも左翼でもないと大衆右翼だとこう言うといた大衆右翼とか右も左もない、日本を愛するとそういうものが集まったんです。それで政治結社にしたわけです。ただし国会議員は出さない。それを出すというとですね、利権とかいろんなものにつながってくる。それで一票発作に国のためにならないことでもですよ。嘘を言わなきゃならんことになる一票発作に。そういうことはいけないから罪悪だから。だから国会議員は出さなかった。
As I said, during that time in Japan, the ideologies prevailing in Japan were becoming very unstable, and also there was lot of fear against attack from overseas. And these are two reasons why some of my friends and I got together to form the party. This is a question which is often asked of me, and I am asked, are you a rightist or a leftist? And my answer is neither. I am for the people, I am for the people of Japan. And my friends who all loved Japan, we got together and formed this body and made it into a political party. Although we made it into a party, we did not send any members to the Diet from our party because that implies various interests. And then when you start sending people to the Diet, you start doing things or trifle things just for the want of one vote. You might have to lie, you might have to do things that you don't want to do just because you want that single vote. For that reason, we did not send any members to the Diet.
See, it is said that Kodama Yoshio also helped you to found this party. Is that true?
Kodama Yoshio-san も一緒にこの党を結成なさったということ
ですね。いや、そうじゃない。
No, that's
それから後に弟子入りをしてきた。
No, he joined us later on.
I see. When did he join?
それはいつもの話でございましたでしょうか。
さあ、それはそうだな。昭和14年ぐらいだったかな。
I think it was around 1939.
I see. Now, did your Kokusui Taishuto, the National Essence Mass Party, have a specific program, a political program?
政治的な何か企画とかですね、活動というもの、具体的なものございましたでしょうか。
これは要は完全懲悪、善を伸ばす、そして悪いものを反省させる、そして優勝劣敗。心象出罰簡素合理化そういう運動を進めた
心象劣罰というのはどういうこと心象劣罰というのは
優勝劣敗、
はい
ねはい、優れたものは勝つ、
はいはい
ね
はい、
それからダメなものは必ずダメになっちまう、はいはい、とは今の世の中は逆だから、
はい
それで心象出罰ということは、はいね、悪いものは罰する、
はい、
いいものは褒める、
はい、
完全懲悪とはすなわち、
ねはい
善を伸ばす、
はい、
で悪を、うん、これをね、反省せしむるということなんこれは日本で一番必要な世界中でもこれが必要それをやっとらんからみんな今世界中ダメになる。
In short, our philosophy was that we would try to promote whatever is good. We would try to promote good and we would try to make people reflect on what sins they have committed or whatever bad has happened. In other words, the good will always win over the evil. Whatever is good, we will praise. Whatever is bad, we will punish. And also simplification and rationalization of the society, of the system. This is something that we need very much today. Japan, well, not only Japan, all over the world, this idea of promoting the good, but also at the same time reflecting back on one's action and realizing when something has gone wrong or somebody has done something bad. This sort of reflective attitude is what Japan lacks, what people all over the world lack, and this is one of the biggest issues, I believe, in the world today.
Did the party undertake any specific activities to promote good and to suppress evil?
その当時ね、日本ではね、大変な不景気で、それで自分の娘さんをね、売らなきゃならない。ね、そういう時代であってもね、政治家は、いろんな大会社と組んでね、それで税金をごまかしてみたりね、そういうことをやったから、そういうものを私が徹底的にやっつけたんだ。悪を凝らしたわけ。
At that time, Japan was suffering from a very deep economic recession, or rather a depression. And with some families, they were so poor and things were so tight with them, some families even had to sell their daughters. Despite such social circumstances, there were politicians who would join hands with private enterprises and make profits, or help them cheat on the taxes, and they would accumulate their own asset. And I was very, very disturbed by this, and I accused them, I attacked them very thoroughly on these politicians who were taking up these actions. I accused them thoroughly.
How many members did this party grow to have?
党員は最終的に何名くらいの？
最大の時には50万ぐらいだよ。
50万人くらい。
当時としては日本で一番人は多い。
At our highest point, we had about 500,000 members. At that time, we were the biggest party in Japan.
And what were the source of funds for the party?
資金源というのはどういったところ？
資金、私金持ちやから。
Well, I'm a pretty well-to-do man, so it came from me.
デュークさんとこと同じ。
Same as the Dukes.
Dukes さんは大きくないけど。
Not anywhere near as them, but I had enough fund to finance the party.
I see.
がもう一つね、私はね、親父から財産を引き継いだと同時に、運勢の強い男なんだ。ね、何をやっても失敗をしないわけなんだ。ただし、そういう場合に儲けようと思う手はやらない。コントロールをするという考えでしか、株であっても、ね、ある日は小豆であっても絹糸であっても、ね、とは日本という国は今も悪いけれども、昔はもっと悪かった。そういう生産者を商社が泣かす、安く取る、それで買うてしまったら今度は高く売って、それで消費者から、生産者も消費者も共に搾取をするというようなことをやっておった。で、当時ね、政党会社というのが、これが政党と一緒になって税金をみんなごまかすんだ。それで私はそれを摘発やった、はい、ね、国民に代わって、それは貧乏人かわいそうだから、はい、そういうところからね、私がもし政治をやっておったらみんながついてこない。一票欲さえなくて、政治やらんから一票必要ないから、そういうところから国民がみんな集まってきた。
Aside, well, actually, I inherited some assets from my father. But aside from that, I must admit that I was born under a very lucky star. I am a very lucky guy. Whatever I do, I never fail. It seems to work.Now, this does not mean that I just make profits after another and accumulate my gain. The idea here is to have an effective control over things. May it be stocks, maybe red beans at one time, it may be silk at one time, but to carry out an efficient control of these things, this is how I achieve it. And in Japan, although the situation still prevails and some things are very bad in Japan, a few decades ago, we had a very unique phenomena where everybody was being exploited, both the manufacturers and the consumers. The big companies would be there in the middle, would buy the products from the manufacturers at a very low price, and then mark it up and sell it at a very high price to the consumers. We had a situation where everybody was being exploited by everyone. And there were also what we called political enterprises. These are companies who joined hands with political parties, and as they said, they cheated on the taxes, they found ways of hiding their income, and these are the establishments which exploited the manufacturers or the consumers or the less privileged people. And I was one of the people, and along with my organization, who disclosed all these things that were being done, and I accused them and I prosecuted them. And if I had been involved or affiliated with a certain political party, I may not have had the sympathy and cooperation of people, because if I was a real politician, I might have to worry about my vote, one vote, the vote here and vote there. But since I did not have to worry about being re-elected or gaining votes, gradually, slowly but surely, I began to win the trust and respect of many, many people.
I'd like to ask you what the opinion of your party, the Kokusui Taishu To, was towards the May 15th incident, the Goichigo Jiken
of
the May 15th incident of 1932.
これはね、私の体験からすると、ね、暴力を振るうということは、結局ね、この舌三寸の使い方を知らない。例えて言うと、笹川良一、死刑印象と、こう死刑や、ね。笹川良一、無罪と言えば無罪になる、ね。舌、はい、三寸というものは、喝殺時代である。その舌三寸をよう使わないから、ね、人を傷つけて殺したりするようになる。それではダメだ。
I would only speak from my own experience, but I believe that violence derives from the fact that one does not know how to use his tongue effectively. In other words, his verbal power he's not aware of, or he's not capable of using that. For example, if somebody says, Ryoichi Sasakawa, death punishment, that's death punishment. Ryoichi Sasakawa innocent, then I'm innocent. That's the power of your tongue, as I call it. It can be used in so many ways to determine the black and white, determine the right and left. It has a great, it can be used as one of the strongest weapons that a human being has. But people who do not know how to use that, the only resort they have is to use violence, and that's not the way you do things. My personal opinion is that's not the way you do things.
Did your party have, the Kokusui Taishuto, have any contact with other political groups that are considered or were considered right-wing groups?
私の方は、大衆右翼である。大衆の意見を、これをね、上達させよう、上達させようという考え。だからそれをはっきり言うとね、正義擁護派なんで、正義、正義を擁護する、そういう考えであるから、それだから人を傷つけたことも一人もない、私に叩かれたものたった一人もおらん、それで私は最後の勝利を得ておる。例えて言うと515事件の思想的なね、師匠は誰かというと大川周明という法学博士である、ね、ところがこれは私と一緒に入った、戦犯で影響ね、 これはそういうことばかりやってるから、そういったところへ入るともう弱い、はい、猫のようになってしまう、はい、だから本当の度胸というものはね、はい、こういうことをやるものは度胸がないんだ、本当の度胸は、はい、あれは決起の所有である、はい、本当の対応というものはね、世のため人のために、限って自分の命を投げ出してでも多数を救うというのが本当のやな、これが勇気である、はい、日本人にはそういうね大きな、国を救う勇気、多数のものを救うための勇気、吉田松陰はあれは大勇である、自分が殺されても人を殺しんかね、それだから偉い。
それであの他の、いわゆる右翼党とされ
たことは弱い、自分こんなことやるから弱い、信念が
ほとんど関係なくて、
一切関係しない、あら観念右翼でありね、はい、それからノリト右翼であり、アメリカのワシン聞いたんだ、はいね、はい、それから暴力右翼であり、はい、あ4つに分類したんで、私の方は右翼やというならば、はい、大衆右翼である、はい、多数の国民を代表する団体であるということを言うと、
はい、Actually, I myself did not want to and did not have、too much to do with the other so-called right-wing partiesBecause as far as I'm concerned, they are ideological right-wing parties. They are violent right-wing parties. Whereas mine, if you would insist on naming it, would be the right-wing party for the mass, for the popular people, the popular right-wing. My concern, my party's concern, was for the upgrading of the status of the individual. And our big goal was to protect justice.To protect righteousness. So I have never hurt anyone. And that's why I am able to win this respect that I have now. And also for the May 15th incident, the person who led the ideological movement in that was a gentleman by the name of Shumei Okawa. But as far as I'm concerned, he does not have courage because he did not act for the good of the people, people who actually went into violent actions. They are not courageous people, no matter what they may claim to be. Real courage is the willingness to give up your own life for the good of many other people.This, I think, is a very important concept, and a lot of Japanese people lack this today. They do not have the courage, namely the willingness to sacrifice yourself for the good of the people. And you mentioned Yoshida Shoin in the little question you had. He had real courage because he was willing to give up himself for the good of the people, of the mass, of the population.
I see. In what ways did your party try to influence national policies? Did you have access to any national leaders or to any politicians? Or did you ever try to elect candidates to the Diet ever during the
1930s?
やはり多数を持つということが必要な、はい、ね、そういうところから、私の日本で尊敬する政治家は、これは一番古い人では犬飼さん、
はい、
体は小さかったけれども、これは立派な政治家だった、
はい、
自分ということを考えていなかった、はい、その次にはまあ吉田茂だった、
はい、
それから後のものはみんなダメだけど、
はい、そういう方、
そういうね、はい、いろんな必要なね、
はい、
連中とは私は付き合うから、悪いものとは付き合わないから。
Of course, I would have very
だから相当な影響を与えた。
I would have close contact with the politician or with the statesman that I respected. I would not have anything to do with thosePeople in the Diet or in the cabinet who I did not respect. One of the politicians that I respect the most in the course of Japanese political history is Mr. Inukai. He was a very small man, but I respect him greatly. He sacrificed himself for the good of the people. Another person I respect greatly is Mr. Shigeru Yoshida. He was a great man. After that, I really don't have anyone who I can really say that I respect. For these people, which I felt are very important and who I respected, I did keep close contact and actually imposed a lot of influence on the national policies.
In 1934 and 1935, as Mr. Sasakawa probably knows well, Professor Minobe Tatsukichi received much criticism for his organ theory of the Constitution, and he was forced to resign from the Diet. What was the attitude of Mr. Sasakawa's party towards Dr. Minobe?
その当時はね、私どもはまだ頭ももう一つね、冴えていないから、
はい、
ね、
はい、
賛成の部分もあったけれども反対の部分もあった、
はい、
ただし今から考えるならば、水戸辰樹さんの言うとることが本当であるというのはですね、今私は右翼から嫌われるのは、
はい、
右翼の諸君は昔と今も同じように天皇と天皇制と一つに考えた、私は2つに考えている。天皇制は日本の象徴であるから、これは誤字する。ただし、人間天皇に対しては絶対誤字ということは言わない。というのは人間であるから、日本の国を売るようなことをやったりしたときには反対しなきゃならない。だから天皇制と人間天皇と2つに考えている。ただ今の右翼というものもほとんど、日本人のほとんどはどちらかに一つに考えとるな、二つに分けるものは私ぐらいのアホやアホだけやなかろうかただし私のが正しいと思うてる。
At that time, I myself as well as my party members may not have been as wise as we are today, and so at that time we said we are partiallyAgainst him, we are partially for him. But today, looking back at what had happened or what is happening, I would say that what Mr. Tatsukichi Minobe said was right. I agree with him. I am all for him. Today, I am often hated by the right-wing parties in Japan. And the reason for that is that the right-wing parties in Japan have not switched their mind. They still think in the way they thought 20, 30, 40 years ago. And I am probably the only person who differentiate between the emperor and the empire system of Japan. The right-wing parties today tend to put this together and describe it by a word empire or emperor and mix these together and take it up as one subject. However, I do not believe that should be done. I believe that the imperial, the empire system in Japan, which is a very, has a long history, has a long tradition, should be observed and kept going. This I respect very much, and it should go on. However, the question of the empire system and the emperor is something different. If the emperor, for example, does something which may have been a mistake or which the people may not like, that has to be made known to the public. It has to be brought up. So I'm probably the only man in Japan who differentiate between these two ideas and take it up separately.
外国人でね、
はい、
今の美濃部辰樹さんのね、
はい
天皇機関説、はい、これを私に質問した人は初めや。
You are
これが一番大事なことだ。
See, this issue is one of the most important issues in discussing about modern Japanese history. And you are the first non-Japanese who have asked a question about this emperor system in relation to Mr. Tatsukichi Minobe.
だから、Minobeさんがね、さっき私がね、 天皇制というのと、はいね、人間天皇とね、はい、2つにね、はい、考えてるでしょ、はい、そういうことをね、その当時言うといてやればね、はい、これは国論が2つになかなか分かれなかった。目の部さんに賛成する人は私は 80% あったと思うな、はい、ガリガあの硬い頭の硬いね、はい、飯食い欲だけは、はい、それは天皇関節結社なんと言うやろうけれども、
So if I had been wise enough to present this theory of this dual theory of differentiation to at that time, I have a feeling things may have been quite different. I have a feeling 80% of the people would have been for Mr. Minobe, and only those very narrow-minded right-wing politicians would have said no.
I see. During the 1930s, were you, or was your party harassed at all by the government?
ASF からですね、かなり圧力を受けましたか、副会長の党は。
あのね、私は圧力というのを恐れない男だ。ええ。だから圧力はいつでもかけるけどね、一向を苦にしないわけなんだ。両親に恥ずることをやらなきゃ欠点を食らえという考えだ。
I'm the type of person who's not disturbed by harassment or pressure. People can give me all the pressure they want, but that doesn't disturb me. I am only disturbed when I do something which goes against my conscience or what I feel embarrassed about. But any pressure that I receive, that does not disturb me.
I see. We read one piece of information that said that at one point Mr. Sasakawa was arrested by the pre-war police. Is that true or false?
それは確かに。
それはね、こういうこと。
戦前の、警察隊に。
そうそうそうそう。それはね、私は今の日本の都市で言うとね、マンで行くから。
はい。
ね。
はい。
マンで行くと29歳の時に自家用の飛行機持っとった。当時は朝日新聞と毎日新聞と私しか自家の飛行機持ってるのもおらなかった、はい、それで30にして今のやな、
はい、
その当時は31や、
はい
日本で初めての防空飛行場を作ったんで今はまあ大したことないけれども1000億ぐらいかかるんじゃないかな今の金にすりゃ、
はい、
だからアメリカのお金にすりゃ、1000億ちょっといくらやな5億ドルか、US ドルの、ね、200円すりゃ、
はい
そういうものをね、作る力を持っておったから、
はい、
それでそれを自分で私は持たないから、作ってもすぐ給付しちまうから、
はい
その当時初めて、
はい、
勲章をくれるんなら給付しないと言うたものは私初めてだった。みんなもうその金を出して男爵が欲しい、勲章が欲しいというのばかりやって、だから売軍事件っていうのが流行ったわけ、うん、勲章を買うわけ金出して、
はいはい、
だからそういうことがけしからんと言って、
はあ、なるほど。
それで私はその当時としてはもう日本で一番の大きな寄付者やけれども勲章も何も持ってなかった、はあ、なるほどね、そういうところが私はみんなから大衆から好かれた、
はい、
なるほどね、ちょっと待って、それから言うてしまった、は
い、When I was only 29, I already had my own airplane. And incidentally, the answer to that is yes, it's true. And at that time, the only person or party, I should say, who had their own private plane was Asahi Shimbun, the Asahi newspaper, Mainichi newspaper, and myself. And at the age of 30, I already had my own airfield.That airfield, if we were to construct it today, I think it would cost over 100 billion yen. And the thing with me is that when I make these or when I construct these, I never keep it for myself. I give it to someone, I donate it, I contribute to it. And however, there was one point, they say that they would like to give me a medal of honor or something for contributing this airfield. And I said, if you're going,to give me a medal or a medallion, I am not going to give it to you. I'm not going to donate it. Because at that time, a lot of people bought titles like being a baron or being a duke or anything like that with money. And this was a very bad practice. And I said, if it's going to look like I paid money to do that, if you're going to give me any title or any medals, I will not donate. And people or some people thought that that was a very scandalous attitude. They did not like me for that. And that's why it's through these actions, I believe, if I may say so, that I have been able to win the trust and confidence of the Japanese people.
日本でね、はい、アホだけれども、一番礼儀正しいのは私じゃないでしょうか。ね、そういうところから、ああいう芸語、すなわち金を持っとるから、位が高いからとお上手言うていかない。貧乏な人にも金持ちの人にも、正しく礼儀正しくやるのが私なんで、ね、で当時私は力を持っとるから、だから当時の警察、特に憲兵、これは大変な力だ。ところがそういうところのものが変わるとね、右翼とかなんとかってはみんな挨拶に行くわけ、私は行かないわけだ。私の方にね変わってきたら、私のところでどんな偉い人でも挨拶に来れば私は当礼に行く、と挨拶に来ないのにね、人のところにねこちらから頭を下げていく必要がないという考えなんだ、そういうところから私が嫌われたわけだ、で生意気だと、ね、何とかしてやってやろうっちゅうんで、ほんで当時私はあえなき権力の打倒論者だ、ね、もう税金でも払わない人はすぐに差し押さえしてやる、はい、ね、とは力のある者は大きな脱税してもね、それで逃れると、はい、そういうことが良くないと、それで平等じゃないといけないというのが私の信念、はい、ところがその当時は警察も買収できれば検事も買収できる、ね、憲兵もこれによってまた頭を下げて買収できる、弱い者いじめをやる、それだから私は嫌いだから、あいな権力打倒論者である、やったってやるまくるもんだから、それだから嫌われて、あいつ生意気だからちゅんでやられたわけだ。
I feel that I am one of the most courteous men in Japan. And when I say courteous, I don't mean just courteous to the well-to-do people or the well-known people. I'm courteous to everyone, to the most underprivileged people. And when at that time I had a lot of power, and the thing is that in many organizations or parties, there's a lot of reshuffling of leaders, and every time there's a structural change in the police, in the thought police, in the right-wing parties, anything, each one would go and bow and scrape and say, how do you do? We look forward to your continued cooperation, so on and so forth. And then the person would have to go back to them and bow and scrape again. And, but I did not have to do that because I was always the leader, and we never had the change of leader. So they would never come to me and bow and scrape. So I did not have to return that. And since I never went them to them and bowed or bowed my head low, they thought they did not like me. They thought I was a very fresh kind of person who did not go to them and pay my respect. And I feel that and at that time I also felt I was very much against power of whether it be the government or the police or the thought police, being used to exploit the poor people. For example, if a very poor person was not able to pay his taxes, immediately he was prosecuted. However, when a big enterprise did not pay or did not report all its income, even if the authorities may have known about it, they may have closed their eyes. And this is something which I could not stand, and that's why I was always against such acts. And in other words, I was very much involved in disclosing these misdoings by the police. I knew that there was a lot of bribery in the police authorities, and I disclosed that, even the police department, the thought police, the government, since I went around accusing them of these things, and since I was able to win the love of the people, they did not like me, and they thought that something should be done about me, because they were, as far as they were concerned, I was their enemy, and that's why I ended up like that.
I see. I have one final question, and that is, we have a report that in 1939 you flew a plane to Italy to meet Mussolini. Is this true? And if it is true, for what purpose did you make the trip?
これはね、私が投獄者らやだ、くくらやだ、
はい
ね、
はい、
そしてその時のことをちょっと言わんとわからないが、なんで私に、長いものは50年もねついてくるかというと、全責任は私が一人で負う、功績は部下に与える、そして、部下の失敗でも善意の失敗は責任を追及しない、それだから少数で、大変な仕事ができるわけな。それで私が投獄せられた時に、30人近く私をくくるために、他の者がもし右翼だから飛行機は持っとるし暴れると困ると言うんで、他の者の幹部を悪くないものを全部くくっちゃって、最後に私を連れてたんだ。その時に私は今言ったように全責任は私一人である、功績は全部部下である、だから全員出せ、私だけ置いとけ、で私が行ったところがそのまま入れちまった、ね、それで私にあなた体当時病気してたから弱いからすぐ出すから、だから泥を吐けっちゅうから、泥がないから吐けん、で私は大将やから全員詐欺出せ、そうじゃなかったら調べを受けん、こう言ったもんだから、ね、5、6年それじゃあぶち込んでこっちゅうから100年で置いとけ、出してくれとは言わんから、そういうところから一人残らず全員詐欺出しまなかったら私が出ない、で部下の悪いことは一つも言わない、全部自分で責任を負ってしまうから、それだから今日でもやな、年のいったら50年も私についとるわけ、ね、そういうことがあったん、
はい、
そこで私が牢屋に入ってる時に、日本では監獄法というものによって、未決まだ悪いかいいかわからん裁判中のものを監獄法というものによって扱っとる、
はい、
懲役人と同じように扱っとるから、これが間違いなんだ、
はい、
で私が司法大臣の中からやかましく手紙出したりして東堂の中改革したわけや、
はい、
ね、もう罪は最終に決まるまでは無罪者であるからけしゃらん、それで花も入るよう、櫛も入れるよう、ポマードもつけるよう、全部改革したんだ私の中を、
はい、
それで最後に私が出てきたわけだな、
はい、
そうするというと私が飛行場なんか給付してるでしょ、
はい、
それで飛行機を持ってるでしょ、無料で飛行士の養成やってるでしょ、
はい、
そういうところから陸軍も海軍も飛行関係はみんな仲いいわけや、
はい、
その時に山本五十六少将が、
はい、
ね、私に海軍の東洋爆撃機一番いいやつ、
はい、
それを2機私にあげるからね、
はい、
ちょっと遊びに行きなさいっちゅうわけ、
はい、
それで大和号というのにして、
はい、
私が行くことになった時に、
はい、
毎日新聞が、
はい、
朝日新聞が王鵬飛行イギリスまでいたんだ、
はい、
日本号とかっていうのでね、
はいはい、
私が牢屋入ってる時や、
はい、
ね、
はい、
で私が出てからやから、
はい、
それに勝ちたいんだ、
あ、
それで私のところ毎日新聞から頼みに来たから、
はい、
私は広告を取る必要も何もないから、
はい、
ね、頼まれたからその飛行機を私が向こうに作家してやって、それで世界一周飛行をやって毎日新聞朝日新聞に勝ったんだ、
はい、
そういう関係で毎日新聞新聞社でも助けてやるから、
それ時にイタリアにお寄りになった、
うん、その時に私にね、気の毒だと、はい、あなたぐらいいいことやってるのはないと、
はい、
にもかかわらずね、
はい、
日本の警察検事があなたを引くってしまうとけしからん、
はい、
それで山本五十六さんが私に遊びに行きなさいと、
はい、
頭の回転をささないかんからというんでよこした、
はい、
やったん、
は
い、でその時にはね、
はい、
私より少し前に、
はい、
海軍の長野大将、
はい、
それから陸軍の寺内大将、
はい、
この2人が ムッソリーニに会いに行ったんだ。だ1週間も経っても会わないわけなんで、忙しいんで、はい、向こうが、
はい、
それで怒って帰ってきたんだ、
はい、
ね、そういうことがあったんだ。そのために私をやった。
なるほど、
はい、遊びに。
To explain this, I have to describe a little background information of my imprisonment. One of my belief is that I will be responsible forEverything, but all rewards and merits will go to my people who have worked for me. So, if there is a failure which is committed by one of my subordinates or one of my followers, if it was a failure caused accidentally, or if he did not intend that to be a failure, if he had done it in good faith, I will not pursue his responsibilities. And, As you may know, I was imprisoned for some time, and at that time 30 of my allies were imprisoned with me, and because they were afraid that I was an extreme ultra right wing party member, and I had an airplane, I had a lot of power, so they weren't satisfied just to put me into jail. They wanted 30 of my members to go along, and I said, these people are not responsible. If you haveto try anyone, if you have to persecute anyone, just blame it on me. I want these 30 people freed. And I insisted that I will not even be subject to inspection until these 30 people are freed. And, well, I insisted so much that I actually became one of the very last person to go out of the jail. And also, I was rather sick at that time.So the jail authorities, the prison authorities told me to confess whatever I have to confess as quickly as possible. But I said, I've got nothing to confess. And as I said, I will not even be put to a trial until my people are free. And they try to frighten me by saying that I'll stay in jail for 5 or 6 years. So I said, okay, I can stay for 100 years if you want. And I just sat back and tried and look at their reaction. And whatever, it's this attitude that, it's this attitude of mine, I will be responsible for everything. My people will get the rewards that have enabled me to have followers who are as old as, some of the people have been my followers for over 50 years. And at that time, people who were imprisoned were subject under the imprisonment law. This was a law whereby those people under trial, in other words, those people who have not even been determined guilty, was treated as criminals. And I said, I thought that this was very unfair. I wrote letters, I made appeals to the Minister of Justice saying that those who are still undergoing trials and for those who has not been determined that he is innocent should not be treated as criminals. And it is through these efforts I made a drastic reformation in the prisons. There were flowers now provided to the people in the prison. They were provided with combs, with hair tonics and things like that. And I was actually responsible for this reformation. And when I finally came out, and I was, like I said, the last one to come out, as I already mentioned, I already had an airfield, I already had an airplane. And Mr. Isoroku Yamamoto, he looked at me and he said, well, you've been through hard times, and I'll give you two planes that the Navy has, two of the best planes. Why don't you take those two planes, rest a while, go around the world and see the world and enjoy yourself. And it was actually on this trip that I went to Italy. Now, while I was in prison, Asahi newspaper had flown a plane to England, and Mainichi newspaper wanted to break that record. So they came to me and they wanted to go further than England or do whatever was better than what Asahi newspaper had done. So this was made into a trip around the world with those airplanes, and Italy was one of the places that I stopped over. Before I had gone to Italy, Nagano of the Navy and Terauchi of the Army had visited Italy and they wanted to see Mussolini. They had waited for a week, but they never got a chance to see Mussolini. He would never receive them. And they came back very, very angry. So now I went to Italy and proved, and I wanted to meet Mussolini and to prove that he could see someone. And so I used this around the world trip, and that was one of the stops I made. ということは最終的にお会いできたわけですね。
そうそう、ところがね、こういうことやって、私が運勢の強い男やから、どういうわけか知らんけれども、喧嘩をしても戦わずして勝つ、ね、相場をやってもね、必ず勝って負けたことを知らん男なんだ、はい、ね、はい、勝とうと思わないんだけれども、その時にね、山本さんがね、長野海軍代表で大将、陸軍代表で寺内がいてもね、合わないんだと。ところが昔のイタリアというのは古事記ばかりだったと。たぶんムッソリニーが天下を取ってからね、もう古事記は一人もおらんと、ね、でムッソリニーは総理大臣であっても飛行機の操縦までやるんだと。それだからそういうね、立派なね、指導者と会って話をしてくるということはね、まことにいいことじゃから行けということやった、そうして私が行ってロールス島で泊まったんだ、ね、そうしたらイタリアがね、翌日は大変な、こんな雪でね、入れないんだ、ゆっかりしなければ、それでイタリアではね、ローマでは雪が透けないから、雪が降るというと雪は幸福を持ってくるというその伝説があるわけや、それでね、大和号で笹川がね、イタリアにね、幸福を持ってきたんだと、こういうことになったわけやな、そうして私から会いたいと言うてないのに、ムッソリニの方からぜひ来いって言ってたんだ。
See, I told you I was born under a lucky star. Whenever I get into a quarrel with someone, I win that quarrel without actually fighting. I've never failed on the stock market either. It's not that I intend to win, but it just happens to be that way. And as I told you, Mr. Isoroku Yamamoto told me that these people from the Navy and the Army, Nagano and Terauchi, they came back frustrated that they couldn't meet Mussolini. And, well, I was actually recommended to go see Mussolini because before they told me that Italy used to be a country full of beggars, and since he's been in power, you don't see any beggars, etc., etc., and I thought it would be interesting to see such a man. So I flew there. I landed in the island of Rhodes, and so it so happens that next day it rained in, it snowed in Rome, and... there seems to be a saying in Italy that snow, which is very rare in Rome, brings happiness. So the Italian people said that this Mr. Sasakawa from Japan on a Japanese aircraft has brought happiness to Italy, has brought happiness to Rome because they saw snow. And it was not that he went and said, I would like to see Mussolini. But since they thought that I was bringing happiness with the snow, he said, come and see me. See, I'm a very lucky man.
そこでね、大抵日本人というものは、大事なことを言わずにお上手だけ言うんだ。とは私は会うなり、ね、当時エチオピアと戦争やっとったから、ムソリニが。で、もしエチオピア戦争で失敗したら、あなたはどういう責任を負う心構えであったかと質問した、びっくりしたんや、こんなね、日本人初めてじゃ言うて、それでね、拳銃に実弾を詰めたものを自分の引き出しから出して、ね、もし失敗したらこれで鉄砲藁をしてね、それで紙皇帝おったから、死も国民に対してね、申し開きをするつもり、責任を負うつもりであったということを言うたんだ。
And what I remember from it is that, well, I'm not a typical Japanese in the sense that I say things outright. A lot of Japanese people would only say socially acceptable things and would not touch on the essence. And at that time, Mussolini was fighting with Ethiopia. And I came out and asked outright, if you fail on this affair that you're having with Ethiopia, are you willing to take the responsibility? Straightforward, just like that. He was taken back and he had this expression on his face. I had never met a Japanese like this. You know, he comes outright and asks a question. And I did ask him whether he was willing to take the responsibility. He took out a pistol from his drawer with bullets in it and he pointed to his throat and indicated that he was willing to take the responsibility.
その時にこういうこと言ったんだ。 あのムッソリーニがねどういうところを見たいかというから、はいね、それだから裁判とそれからあの留置場と刑務所を見せてくれてた、はい、ね、はい、そしたらびっくりしまったわけ。え、なんでそういうところを見るかというと、はい、お互いの家でも玄関は綺麗だが裏の方が悪い。
あ、そうですね、
はい、だから表から入って大抵表だけ見せて裏を見せないからわからないわけだ、はい、私の場合は表やからどうだ入れと言われたら裏へ出てくるわけだ、はい、そうすると表と裏とを見てそれを一つにしてしまう。それをポンと二つに割ったものが正しい、それがあの値段なんだ、はい、評価ができる、
はいはい、じゃあのこの後おそらく質問を答える人がいると思います、うん、And he was very also surprised. Mussolini asked me where I would like to see, and I said I would like to see the court hearings and the prison. And he was very surprised because not many visitors from abroad want to see that. But too many people just show visitors the clean part of the things, the front facade, and they fail to show the other side. And for example, I'm the type of person, if I'm shown the front gate, which everybody keeps very, very nicely and clean, I will always end up on the back door. And I believe that the true value of something is the best part of the house, which is the front facade and the back entrance put together and divided by two. So this is, well, this is the reason I told Mussolini I wanted to see those two things.
So the most important thing, just a minute, this is a big thing. What is it? What is it? At that time,空軍省行った。そしたら誰が仕事をやってるか全部分かるようにそこに時間がデンと座ってね全部見えるようになっておる。それから便所行ったんだ、うん、そしたら便所はねもう男女別でね、うん、それだけしかないんだ。ところが当時日本は便所行くというと陸軍でも海軍でも召喚用ね、左官用、左官いかん用、商工用やな、うん、それと貸し官用と3つになってね、小便するんでも、うんね、で私が帰ってきたところは陸海軍の偉い者が全部集まって私の歓迎会やってくれたんで、その時にもうそれにお見習いなさいと、うん、ね、戦争に行きゃ同じように鉄砲弾を受けるんじゃないかと、ね、出る者は皆やな、大将もやな、ね、兵隊も無駄じゃないかと、それに3つに区別するとは何じゃったの、やめ。
While I was in Italy, I had the occasion to visit their Air Force headquarters, and what I found, or what I was very impressed by, was the, I visited the gentleman's room, and I was very surprised to find that there were only two distinctions in the toilet, for ladies and for gentlemen. Now in Japan, at that time, the toilets used to be ranked at least in three stages, for the generals up, for the middle level, and for the soldiers. Each rank had its own toilet. And when I came back from my around the world trip, the Navy and the Army and the Air Force people got together to hold a welcome home party. And at that party, I said, you should see what they do in Italy. When we fight, when we're in a war, regardless of the question of whether you're a general, or you're an admiral, or whether you're a soldier in the lower ranks, we are all exposed to the bullets from the enemy force, and what we discharge is all the same. So why should we have three different ranks in toilets? That's what I call equality, and I made a speech on that, and people were rather impressed by that.
I would like to start with a personal question, if I may, and I'd like to ask you to say a few words about your early life, where you were born, what your family life was like, and what you did as a young man.
あのね、現在は名前が変わったわけやな。大阪府、今は箕面市、小野原というところに生まれた、はい、うん、それで親父の商売は造り酒屋、
はい、
酒造業、
はい、I was born in a city called Mino City in the Osaka Prefecture, western part of Japan, and my father's profession was winemaking, liquor making.
で、どういったような、幼年生活、青年
生活。私はね、男が3人、女がね、3人なんだ。ところが、2人女が早く死んじゃってね。はい、そして子供の自分は私は大変な、ガキ大将でね、手に負えないんだ。
はい、
うん、そしてノーベル賞をもらった川端というのをね、
はい、
それと学校の子供の自分から友達なんだ。彼はなんか学問好き、私は日本一の恩師やからね、
はい、
あれの時には学校に行かないんだな、その音楽の時間は、
はい、
とは悪いことできないもので、急に雨が降ってきてね、
はい、
それでその日は運悪く学校行ってないんだ、
はい、
ね、と雨降ったもんだから傘を持ってね、親父が母が番頭に迎えに起こした、はい、今日は笹川学校に来とらんちゅうわけな、
はい、
それで蔵へ入れられたり縛られてあげられたり、夜お墓にね物を置いてあるから取ってこい、ああそれするとまた今度はお宮さんに物を置いてあるから取ってこい、私は小さい自分が恐ろしいこと知らんアホなんだね。その時に私の母がね、悪いことは内緒である、必ず人の見るところに現れるからね、することにならんと。でちゃんとそれ私は露見してること知らないわけなんだ、私はね。それだからお前のような子供を産んでな、もう本当にね将来が心配じゃから、お前と一緒に死んでしまいたいというわけやな。だから今の7つだな、昔は数えやから、
はい、
1年生の時、はい、それからもう両親に恥ずることを悪いと思うことは絶対やらんことにしたから、どんな時が来て警察検事やな裁判官税務署が見ておっても平気なんだから、私ぐらい税金を正しく、こんなね果物一つもらってもそれを計算して全部税金払うから、だから税金戻してくるのはわしだけや。だから人が何とやろうと思っておっても平気や、いいことばかりしか出てこないから。
I was born in a family with three sons and three daughters. Unfortunately, two of my sisters died at a very early age. When I was a child, I was a real rascal. People just couldn't control me. I was the bad kid in the school. And I happened to go to the same school as Yasunari Kawabata, author and winner of the Nobel Prize. And although we were in the same school, we were quite different. He's the type who liked studying very much. His marks were always good, whereas I was the rascal. And for example, I hated my music class because I'm the worst singer in the world. And whenever we had music class, I would cut that day. I would play hockey on that day. Now, unfortunately, when that happened once, it started raining. So my mother was very worried, and she sent one of our house servants to pick me up at the school with an umbrella. He goes to the school, and the school says, oh, he didn't come to school today. So there it is. The fact that he was playing hockey is all of a sudden revealed. And when these things happened, I would be punished, of course. For example, my mother would send me to the graveyard at night because she claimed there was something that had to be picked up there. Or she would lock me up in the warehouse, and I was punished a lot. And one of these big blows came when I was 7 years old, and my mother told me to sit down, and she told me that even if you think you've done, you can keep secret some of the things you've done. Whatever bad things you've done, somebody will know and it will be revealed. So you can never be, you will always be guilty for what you've done. And ever since that day, I have not done anything. I've not lied. I have not hidden anything. And that's why I am not afraid of anything. There is no psychological burden that I carry. The police may come, the whole court may come, or the Internal Revenue people may come. I have nothing to fear. I have everything, I have done everything clean, the taxes are paid, and I like I said, from that year, 7 years old, from that age of 7 years old, I have done nothing that I'm ashamed of.
You've said many times that you do not view Japan's conduct in China after 1931 as aggression. So I would like to ask how you would characterize the Japanese presence on the mainland after 31 and after 37, and ask why Japan did move onto the mainland in those years.
日本は元国城、元国城というと下の者がね、上の者の言うこと聞かないんだね。それだから辻正なんてのはおったでしょ、参謀で、作戦の神さんとか言うと、あんなも神さんじゃない、基地がや、私が言わしたら、自分が手柄を立てるために上の者の言うことを聞かなくて、勝手に兵隊をどんどんどんどん出して、むちゃくちゃやってしまう、それをまた上の者が容赦えない、だから日本はパンクした。
At that time in Japan, we had a very sad situation where the people were not capable of listening to the superiors. They would not lend their ears to what the wise superiors had to say. For example, you had Masaru Tsuji. He's referred to as the genius of tactics, but as far as I'm concerned, he was an insane man because he wanted all the merits for himself. He did not listen to his superiors. He took the liberty of just sending soldiers off and going on progressing to the continent. And at the same time, the people above, the superiors, did not have the power to control them, people under them. And that was a very bad situation, and that is why it happened.
So do you feel it was unwise then for the Japanese government to establish a presence on the mainland after 1937, that there was no justification for it, and that it was all a result of pressures coming up from the military below?
It was not a wise thing to do.
それともう一つは、向こうは向こうで軍閥がたくさんおって、一部の日本の兵隊、政治家とくっつく、こちらの方はくっつく、また向こうは向こうで。ね、それは喧嘩やっとるわけや、それと日本の一部のものとくっついて、結局はそういうもののバランスが崩れて大きな戦争になっちまった。
And it was very unfortunate because on the mainland as well, they had lots of military factions, and this military faction would join hands with this Japanese faction, that military faction would join hands with this Japanese faction, and that sort of built up into what might have started as a very small incident, was built up into a total imbalance and instability of the situation, leading into a great big war.
Well, is this kind of pressure operating in the military then a continuous, or say at the middle or lower levels of the officer corps, does that represent a continuous feature of Japanese public life, or is that a peculiar feature of the 30s? And if it's peculiar to the 30s, why did it develop then and not at another time?
もう今はすっかり変わってしまった。
なぜ1930年代にそういった
傾向は、その当時はね、こういうこと、日本では三菱というものが、三菱、これは両方が政友会という今のその自民党だな、それを三井が抱えとるわけ、県政会その反対党は三菱が抱えとるわけや、そうして利権を取らなきゃならない、外国でも戦争やらしちゃ儲けなきゃならない、そういう力も動いた。
The same does not apply for today, but the question as to why it happened in 1930, we must also take note of the other factor at that time, which was the existence of a rivalry between House of Mitsui and then Mitsubishi. Now, each of these also had their own supporting parties. Mitsui had the Seiyukai, and the Mitsubishi had the Kenseikai, and Seiyukai happens to be the predecessor of the Liberal Democratic Party today. but what they had great power, and they would agitate things in and out of the country, especially out of the country, and they would manipulate things so that there would be an outbreak of war. And of course, their main interest was to benefit and profit from that. So that's another factor which has to be taken into consideration when we discuss about the 1930s.
I'd like to ask a few questions about the wartime diet. It's sometimes seen as being an entirely monolithic affair, namely the Yokusankai, without any real divisions or influence. So I wanted to ask if there were meaningful debates within the Yokusankai, if the divisions within it followed the lines of the former parties, left and right, Seiyukai and so forth, and whether or not the influence of the Yokusankai, whether or not the Yokusankai really influenced policy, or if the policies always came down from the government.
ヨクサン会には入れないわけなんで、言うこと聞かんから、僕はジェジェン主義者やから。
Well, Yokusankai as such had no power whatsoever. This was this consisted of people who would listen to Tojo. That was an exclusive group, only those people who listened to Tojo. So they wouldn't accept me. For example, even if it's my mother or father or my relatives who have told me something, if that thing is wrong, even if it's from a recommendation or advice from a family member, what is wrong is wrong. If the recommendation or advice comes from a stranger, if it's right, it's right. And that attitude they didn't like, they wouldn't, of course, include me in the Yokusankai. And I, of course, campaigned on my own outside of them, and they went around tearing my posters. They really didn't like me.
A diet member named Nakano Seigo was forced to leave the diet in 1943 because of his independent position. He was also an admirer of Mussolini, sometimes described himself as a right-winger, and was very much influenced by Oyome thought. Now, I wondered what you felt about Nakano and his expulsion, and if you made any efforts to resist that expulsion, and if you were also influenced at some point or to some degree by Oyome philosophy, Wang Yangming Confucianism.
悪いことをね、あなた、あれを殺しなさいと、こう言ったら共産になるね、これになるね。ね。俺なら、あれはやっつけちまうな。こう言って人がそれを真似した場合にはね、罪にならない。共産にならない。そういうことまで僕らは引っかかってるからね、良い周到やから。だから中野君の場合は、これはね、そういう目にあっとらんから、
流事しられるというと、そんなもんその昔は洋式便所なんかないから、だからこんなあれが箱があるわけよな。それは石油缶2つ入る箱、そこへ穴開けとけるわけや。その上に乗っかってやな、これその大便まで線だからな。それでね、先生先生言うてもらえると思うけれども、あそこへ入ればね、この野郎やっつけてやれって言うんでね、いじめよるわけや。
それに、耐えかねたことが一つと、もう一つはね、正直やから、あなた流言飛語やりましたねってこう言って質問しよる、憲兵や警察が、何がやな流言飛語やと、そんなら証拠言いなさい、石原幹事中将がこう言うた、東国の皆さんがこう言うた言うから、よろし、それじゃ一つ引っ張るかいとこうなるわけや。 そういうところからね、責任を 自分が追わなかったら向こうが呼ばれるから、ね、はい、だから侮辱に耐えかねたということと、はい、正直すぎちゃから、はい、人の名前を言うてしまった、はい、責任をね、自分が追うか相手に追わすかせんならんから、はい、その二つで自決をした。
なるほどね、うん、あ、自決なすったんですね、
うん、私なら自決しない、はい、でまたするような下手なこと言わんから、
As concerns Mr. Nakano, well, he had some trouble with his leg, and he had never been in a prison, and he was also very awkward with his way of speech, and he really didn't know how to get along in the world. There are a lot of things that, little tricks that you must learn. For example, if you said that man's doing something bad, kill him, then of course you'll be accused of having partaken in the killing. But if you say, gee whiz, that's a bad man, I wish somebody would kill him, and then somebody else kills him, you're not responsible for that. That sort of little tricks, and these are things that you have to learn, and you learn when you suffer a lot through the in life. But this man happened to not be exposed to too many, training in life, and also he was too honest, let's say. He was a very naive, honest man, and when he was inspected and when he was questioned, he would easily just give names like that. He was just too a naive and honest man, and that's why he could not, since he was in that sense a weak man, he could not withstand the insult he got, and also because of his being too naive and too honest, he ended up taking his own life.
What are your thoughts on the causes of Japan's defeat in the Great Pacific War? In what institutions or policies do you see responsibility? Was the tragedy avoidable in some way? And if so, how?
これはね、初めから負けること分かっとった。ね、というのは陸海軍の軍人中で私はもうほとんど知っとるけれども、そのうちで一番ね腹を割って話をして先の見えるのがね、山本五十六元帥である、ね、これは私にこう言った。最後はこれはね、座して滅びるか戦ってね武士に一生を売るか二者択一であると、ね、ところが一年半しか持たないと、最初はタコの手ほど足を広げて勝って勝って勝って見せると、1年半しか持たないから、はい、ね、はい、それだから戦争というものでも旅行と同じでどこへ行ってスケジュールをやっぱりそう作っとかんなんですよ、はい、ね、はい、それについてはね、シンガポールをね、これを日本が取った時に温かい手をイギリスに差し伸べると、はい、ね、そうするといい条件で平和ができると、もしそれをもう済ましてしまったら大変なことになると、はい、日本は、はい、というのは、はい、シンガポールを捉えたら今度は次はビルマ、インドだと、はい、インドを捉えてしまったイギリスというものは年寄りから怒った、はい、安価を取ったようなものじゃと、はい、ね、それについては政治的にね、それを解決しなきゃならんと、はい、一番いい時に、はい、こういうことじゃ。それでどのぐらいの時間かかるかといったら半年かかると言ったんだよ、
シンガポールを取るのに、
はい、ああ、ね、はい、党は半年どころかもうその2つかね、2月半で取っちゃったんだ、驚いてしまった、はいはい、その時に私にね、あなたは陸海軍をみんな知ってるから、はい、ね、はい、そういう時にそういういい手を打ってやな、うまく収めるようにやな、うん、一つ政治をやってくれと言うから、私がいやいやながらね、みんなから邪魔せられて憲兵や警察から、それで初めて出たんだ。
It was known from the beginning that we were going to lose that war. At that time, Isoro Yamamoto was one of my closest acquaintance in the military circles, and he said that at any rate this is not a winning war. Either we will have to give in, compromise sometime, or we will just have to fight until we destroy ourselves. And he clearly said that at best we would last for a year and a half, but we were going to lose it. And he also said, and I agree with this, that even in a war, it's like taking a trip. You have to schedule it right. You have to know where you're going and what you do when. And he said that the best scheduling is first for Japan to take Singapore, because he was pretty sure even though we were going to lose it, in the first phase, the first phase of the war, we would be winning one after the other. So he said that we would take Singapore, and at that stage, approach England, and that was the best time to conclude a peaceful agreement with the best conditions, mutually. And because if we had missed that chance, we would just go on and things would be out of control. We would take Burma, we would take India. That was the course of action that people were forecasting. And he said it will probably take 6 months for Japan to take Singapore. What happened? It didn't take 6 months. It took, what, 2 months or 2.5 months? We were all excited. And, well, because Ms. Yamamoto knew about this, he came to me and said, well, Sasakawa, you're a very close friend of mine, and since I believe in this scheduling of approaching United Kingdom after we take Singapore, could you work out the political side? So I was a bit reluctant about it, but that's the reason, despite all the objections, I try to do that in my own way.
I'd like to ask you a few questions about the post-war period after the end of the war. In 1945, I understand you were jailed as a war criminal, and I understand also that in 1946, you were also purged for political activity during the war. I wonder if you could clear up for me what activities caused you to be charged as a war criminal.
私はね、飛行機を持って、飛行場を持っておった。ね。そうして国会議員ですから。そういうところから、私は、永久戦犯になるかならんかわからなかったんだけれども、日本が負けた以上はね、大臣も国会議員の偉いのも、総理大臣も大将もみんなくくられるでしょ。みんな素人やから。 ね、裁判知らないから、私は前に3年入れられて、4年よたび裁判やって、最後まで無罪ばっかりやから。ね、裁判のこともよく知っとるから。それで私があの中へ入ってね、みんな教えてやろうと。こういう気持ちがあったから、それでね、自分の選挙区で25ね、5、6箇所演説やったんで、1人で、何時間ずつ。ね。 そうせんと他のもんやらしたらくくられたら気の毒じゃから。それでもしね、私がくくられたら、日本の立場を明らかにするから、ね、みんな祝杯をあげてくれという演説をやる。そういうところからね、私をくくってくれたのはマッカーサー元帥。それだから私が学隊入りで入ったりして、中でね、やってやりまくったから。で、今日ね、私の進化が現れたのはマッカーサー元帥がくくってくれたならこそ、 私がね、どういう人間であるということがよくわかるようになったから、マッカーサー元帥に私は感謝しとるわけ。
I was a member of the Diet at that time, and since we had lost the war, people were pretty sure that everybody would be thrown into jail, all the ministers, the prime ministers, various officials, and but these people were really scared to death because they really didn't have the faintest idea what it was to be thrown into jail. Whereas I was experienced, I had done it for 3 years before that, and I had gone through a lot of, you know, investigation, inquiries, and trials. So I was quite an expert in it, let's put it that way. So if somebody went around making nationalistic speeches around the country, he was sure to be thrown into jail. So before they had a chance to do that, I, on my own, went around and in about 25, 26 places, just gave speeches so that I would be the one to be thrown into jail and could take place of these people who were not as experienced, let's say, in jail life. And I told them, if I am ever thrown into jail, you should drink a toast to me, because then I will be able to really tell the people about the true feelings of Japan. So I told them, if I'm the day that I'm thrown into jail, they should toast a drink for me. And it was at that time, as you know, the occupation forces were there. So it's very easy for them to catch me and accuse me and throw me into the jail. But and it was actually General Douglas MacArthur who did this. But as you know, after I went into jail, I was very active, and I was the foundation for my being what I am today was a lot of that was nurtured in the in my years in the prison. So I am really, really grateful for General MacArthur for throwing me into the into prison, because what I am now, I really owe it to him.
そこでね、こういうこと。あの、アメリカ人はね、どういうことがね、私が好きになったかというとね、本当のことを言うのは好きだ。逃げるのは嫌いだな、アメリカ人は。ね、私はもう命捨てるつもりで言っとるもんだから。だからやりまくるわけや。そうするとね、こう言ってきた。検事がね、そうかと、それはね、日本とソ連は喧嘩してないんだ、不可侵条約はまだあるんだ、それを黙って兵を満州カバフに進めたの、ね、そのソ連が裁判官と検事をね、立会せしめるということは将来侵略戦争の奨励となる。だから私はね、戦意が破れるから反対である、俺は命がけでやってきたんだ、だからアメリカと喧嘩するつもりはないんだ、ソ連をやっつけるんだと、こういうことで、そうしたらアメリカ人がね、分かったと、検事がみんな手握って、そういうお前は考えやったからね、学隊で入ってきたりね、演説ばかりやりよったんだと、分かった分かったって言って喜んで、それから私にいろんな意見を聞くんだ、このままでいったらどうなるかとかね、だから私はこのままでね、あなた方がね、共産主義者をね、出したりなんかしとると、あんた方必ず困ることになるぞったら、それがなってきたからね、私にはな、お前すぐ出すから、フィリピン人、台湾人、朝鮮人みんな聞いても、ミスター笹川以外にね、共産党と太刀打ちやるやつおらんと言うから出すからと、こう言うから、協力者やつからわしはやめやした、日本一国をね、くれても私は日本を売ってまでね、協力はできん、英雄出してもらえてもよろしい。でその時にこう言った、面白いな、アメリカ中検事は話が分かるとね、タバコ耐えて怒っとったけど、今度はみんな握手をして、タバコはくれる、チューインガムはくれる、友達はもう、ね、お前みたいな男初めてやと言って、それで、第1回の大戦の時に、ヒフテーというベルリンの大学の教授が、みんな失望落胆している時に、5、6箇所演説やって、ね、諸君は失望落胆する流れと言ったと。とはミスター笹川はね、二十数箇所やっとると、数においても激烈さにおいてもね、ヒフテーの問題ではないと、だから世界ナンバーワンじゃって、テーマって喜んでくれた。
I forgot to mention in the previous statement that I was the only one in the history probably who hired a brass band to follow me when I was thrown into jail. And I want to mention that a lot of Japanese, they are very, very aggressive, and they sound strong when they're winning a war, when they're winning a quarrel. But when it comes to being thrown into a jail, a lot of them came up with fake ailment. But I was very proud. I proudly went into the jail with a brass band following me. And what I like about the Americans is that they are very open, and they will say whatever is actually being done or being implemented. And for example, when I was in jail, I was actually able to found a very close friendship with the American authorities, because I mentioned that I have no intention, or I never had an intention of quarreling or fighting with the Americans. If there's any power we had to fight with, it was the Soviet Union, because we had a treaty which was still valid at that time, and there were problems with that. And the interesting thing which I learned then was that with an American, the American authorities there, they may have been very, very rough and tough and rude on me, but once they understood that there was some sort of a common interest, or that once we figured out that we understood each other, he would just jump on and out of his desk, shake hands, offer me cigarettes, offer me chewing gum. They were so friendly, and that sort of attitude I really like. And I also told, since that friendship, the Americans sort of started lending their ears to what I had to say. I also warned them about communism, and at one point they said, okay, we'll free you, because you seem to be the only person who can fight communism in this part of the world, and we would like you to act on our behalf to fight communism. But he said, no, not for anything could I leave Japan or sell Japan. And it was said that during the First World War, a professor from the Berlin University made speeches in 5-6 places encouraging people, don't be depressed, don't be discouraged, and which was a very positive, had a very positive effect on the people. But they learned that I had made speeches in 25-26 places, which was many times more than what the professor from Berlin had done, and they were very, very impressed, actually.
I'd also like to follow this point about a developing friendship with the officials in the American occupation. There is a lot of controversy and interest in the personalities of certain leaders in the American occupation. Naturally, General MacArthur himself, and also General Willoughby, who was head of civil intelligence. I understand you got to know these people, and I wonder if you could tell us about them as members of the occupation.
これはね、マッカーサー元帥はね、行儀がよろしい。日本主義と礼儀正しい。天皇に対しても。ところがね、上と下とやっぱしね、日本の軍隊と同じことでね、いいのもおるし、悪いのもおるわ。それでドレイバーさんが日本にやってきて、それで占領政策を是正してくれたからね、それだから日本の今日はある。あの人が来なかったらね、日本は今頃ね、石化してね、もう中国やソ連みたいになってしまうと。それだから私はドレイバーさんをね、尊敬しとる。
General MacArthur was a very courteous man. Courteous to the Emperor, courteous to Japan. He was a gentleman.And as in any organization, or as in Japanese army, within the occupation forces, there were those who were very good, there were those who weren't as good. You know, they were the good and the bad. So there was a great difference, as you mentioned, in the individualism of each person. And also I have to mention Mr. Draper, who came to Japan and rectified the various occupation policies in Japan. Without him, I think Japan would today have ended up in a very lowly situation, or not as developed as it is. Maybe it may have been on the same line with Soviet Union or China. So I am very thankful for Mr. Draper, and that's the reason I really respect him.
私はね、こういったことを言った、マッカーサー元帥に、今度の戦争でもう最終にしてもらいたい、それには世界一家人類兄弟じゃなかったらダメだと、それだから恒久の平和をね、作ってもらいたい、それについては裁判は中立側に渡してくれ、で勝った方負けた者も戦争放棄廃反した者はね、裁判を受けましょうと、そのためにもしね、恒久の平和を作ってくれたら、その記念式典に私の体をお供え物にあげるから。
And he said that when he talked with General MacArthur, he said, I want this to be the very last war. And for that, what we have to do is create a world that is one and where all mankind are brothers and sisters. And for that, we must carry out fair justice, regardless of the nationality, being an American or Japanese. They have to be tried fairly. And if the realization of a peaceful world, as I imagine, is materialized, and when that time comes, I will be glad to give my soul and my body to you as a gift. That's what I said to him.
その時に33年の前に、33年今から前に、これは戦争をもうやめてしまいたいという私の、ね、願いです。
And 33 years ago, the piece of paper I just gave you is what I drew up, expressing my desire for a peaceful world without war.
Your activities since you were released in 1948 have been devoted to a lot of philanthropic objectives. I wonder if you could tell us what you have been doing to realize the aims in your resolution.
それをするにはね、私はね、開闢以来、世界ができてから、はい、ね、兵隊と言わず、民間人と言わず、はい、戦争で亡くなった人、はい、ね、その人の遺灰を私は背負ってるそうな、はい、だから命がけなんだ、はい、そして世界中をですよ、はい、きれいな住みよい戦争のない世の中を作ろうという考えを持っておる、はい、それについては私が政治をやっておるとね、はい、これダメです、はい、一票欲しいためにね嘘も言わなきゃならないことになるから、同時にまた人間一番がね責任を負わないか、我々戦争中の代議士だから、国会議員だから、ね、負けたんだから、負けた者が再び出ることはよくない、こういう私は考え、その2つから範を垂れとるわけや、はい、そして時代社会か人類経定姉妹主義じゃなければ世界の平和はね来ないということを今日まで33年間言い続けておるわけや、
はい、具体的な活動としてはどういった、
具体的な活動はですね、これは、うん、やはり平等じゃないといけません、はい、人間は、はい、ね、とは平等であってもです、それは権利は平等なの、しかしただ権利だけを主張して義務を負わないということはいけない、はい、とは今日までの日本の政治は金持ちを富ますための政治だった、これ良くない、はい、とは現代はね、これまた行き過ぎてね、はい、文句ばっかり言って働かん者がねいいこと承知していいやから、はい、これはいけません、はい、だから日本だけではない、世界中、アメリカも私はそういったことになりつつあると、これはよくない、はい、だから勧善懲悪、いいものを進める、悪いものは反省させる、ね、それで一生懸命働く者は働くようにする、働かん者は食わせたりかん、病人と年寄り以外はね働かないものはこことならんということの先頭ですよ、ヘルプツばっかりで日本なんかでもね、やはり何でも反対反対で旗振って、はい、ね、はい、それでデモじゃストじゃと言って、それで勝手気ままやって、それで人に迷惑をかけ、自分らだけいいことして、それで組合員だってそのため悪いんだ、そんなのみんなぶっ飛ばさなきゃならんちゅうわじゃ考えて一生懸命やるわけ。
Well, my activities, post-war activities, have been very, very serious, and I have thrown in, I have exerted all of my efforts to it because I feel that I am carrying the burden of all the soldiers or the people who have sacrificed their lives in the war. It doesn't matter whether they were soldiers or people, the public, everybody who sacrificed their lives, I have to carry out activities in their stead, and I'm very, very serious about this. More concretely, my goal is to is the materialization of a world, a clean world, a comfortable world, and a peaceful world. I would really like to see this realized, and to be involved in such activities, I could not have continued to be a politician, because when you are a politician, you're worried about your votes, you're worried about the voters, so sometimes you cannot do what you would really like to do, you must sometimes lie, and you're so concerned about the vote in your next election that you cannot really undertake activities you would have liked to. That's why I withdrew from the political world, and for 33 years I have been advocating my ideology, which can be expressed in the world is one family, and all mankind are brothers and sisters. And this is based on the understanding that all human beings are equal. yes, human beings are equal, and for a long time, the Japanese government was a government where it worked to the advantage of the well-to-do. Of course, this is not good. A lot of well-to-do people or companies profited from the government of Japan. That is not good. But the sad thing is that recently the trend has been reversed, that those people who complain the most and who don't even work for their own rights get what they ask for. This is not only the problem in Japan, but I think the United States is experiencing this. All the countries all over the world are experiencing this. I feel that aside from the old people and the handicapped, sick people, everybody must work for their rights, and they must work to eat. But today there are so many people who just complain and they talk about their rights and they demand their rights without working for them. There are these people who constantly engage in demonstrations and wave their big flags saying they have title to this, they're entitled to that, without really looking back on what they have done for the society. And this, I think, is very bad. And these are the people who usually end up causing trouble to other people or causing trouble to society. These people, I think, are really people that I despise.
Thank you very, very much.
どうもありがとうございました。
日本もね、外国からね、やってきた人が、ね、働かないで、それで文句を言ってる。税金払わなくて。その上にね、我々の税金をね、生活補助を受けて食ってんね。そんなやつに限ってね、日本を混乱させることやってんね。
We have the problem in Japan also. Some people coming, just entering Japan like that and not working to earn their bread or their rice, maybe I should say, but using up the taxpayers' money. And a lot of times these people are those with the loudest voice about complaining things, or they may have they may contain the elements for destroying Japan. This is a very, very bad tendency.
これはね、どこの国でもそういうことさせちゃいけません。働も達者で若いのに働かずに食っとるやつはね、もうその食わしちゃいけません。
No country should tolerate that those healthy people who can work, if any of them don't work and just sit and complain, they don't deserve to eat. No country should tolerate that.
This is the last question.
Professor McKean, are you going to do that?
Yes.
Any time.
I wonder if you could tell us in a concrete way, very briefly, the kinds of activities you're involved in through the United Nations.
その活動を私の、
ええ、そうです。
あ、これはね、私は国連というものはね、必要だと思います。はい、世界か人類経定姉妹主義をね、実践、強行する組織としては誠にいいと思う、
はい、
いいと思いますけれどもですね、国連最高の理想は世界の恒久の平和を確立して人類をね、永遠に戦争の災いから救うということだね、
はい、
とは30年以上経ってもやな、やっぱり至る所で戦争やっとる、はい、やっとるというのは結果なんだ、
はい、
原因のない結果ないんだ、
はい、
原因はどこにあるかというと、
はい、
世界というものがあって、アメリカがあり、日本があり、イスラエルがあり、エジプトがあるね、
はい、
ね、
は
い、そういうことを忘れてしまって自国本位のね、勝手気ままな議論ばっかりやっとるからやな、ほら、その平和は来ないんだから、
はい、
ね、
はい、
それならあんた年中総会理事会やったって三分の価値もないから、だから自国を愛するというものじゃなければ世界を愛することはできない。自分の団体を愛するものじゃなければ自分の国を大事にしない。自分の国を愛せないものは世界を愛することはできないけれどもですよ、
はい、
ね、
はい、
もっと対極に立って物事を考えなきゃいかん、
はい、
とは今の世界中どこ見てもね、ああいう迎合政治、ああいう迎合とはね、すぐに悪いやつの味方するようなね、政治ばっかりやっとるからダメです、
はい、
だからやっぱり一番大事なのはね、これは人口問題、ドレーバーさんやってらっしゃる、これは私は 力はありませんよ、リュークさんの10分の1もありませんけれどもね、精神的に私はこれは、お手伝いさせてもらっと、はい、というのは人口が増えれば、はい、食うもの、ね、着るもの、はい、それから酸素、はい、酸素がなかったら大変でしょ、
そうです、ね
ね、ところが木は切り倒しまうわ、海は油で汚すから軽い酸素が出ないでしょ、人間が増えるから、そうすると酸素の配給量がね少なくなるから、50年先になったらね、これは人間生きられなくなると思うんだ私は、そういうところからまず人口問題でお手伝いをさせてもらう、はい、ね、そんなものを無造作にたくさん産んでもう一人前になるまで半分死んでしまいな、そんなつまらん蘇生乱造やっちゃいかん、いい品物を作ると同じように、はい、子供もやない、子供を丈夫な子供を少数作った方がよろしい、
はい、ちょっとそれで、I think that United Nations is a very necessary organization for, and I think its purpose is to realize and the perpetual peace of the world. And however, when we look at its history, it's been there for 30 years, I guess, and we look at the world, we still have nations fighting, we have wars outbreaking here and there. And this is because United Nations, unfortunately, recently has turned into a place of debate where people just debate and argue, only thinking of their own country, of only thinking of their own interests. They must realize that only when we have this earth, when we have a global view, can we expect the existence of United States, the existence of Japan, the existence of Israel, existence of Egypt. And everybody seems to lack this idea. They are very, very becoming very, very egoistic. And one of the fields in which I am, I hope I am contributing and I'm doing my best to support it, is the population activities. I think the population issue is one of the biggest problems that the world is facing today. And for example, I am supporting the Draper Foundation in their population activity, because population control is the key to a better world. When there's more people, too much people, you have problem with food, you have problem with clothing them, you have problem with the lack of oxygen because too many people, and then they've cut down the trees and the oil pollutes the sea and you do not get enough oxygen. So the population must be controlled, and this is one of the fields in which I am quite active and I hope to continue supporting.
そういうところから海をきれいにする、ね、そのためにアメリカばかりに、ね、世話になってちゃいかんです、日本もできることはやっぱりしてな、
はい、
ね、そういうところからね、あそこへ、筑波大学にうちが1本で35億円ですか、
はい、
2、3年前に出してね、はい、それで海を汚したらどういうふうにしてきれいにするかという研究所を作って年々再生金出してんです、はい、だ汚す方の船会社一銭も出さんからこの間呼びつけてしかったんだよ。
In that relation, I'm very concerned with the environment problem. I feel that we must purify our seawater, our environmental protection, and we cannot always ask the United States to bear the responsibility. We must also develop our own system of environmental protection, a concrete way of doing this being my contribution to the Tsukuba new academic town. I contributed 3.5 billion yen for the research of purifying seawater from its pollutants. So, and the pollutant fishing companies and shipbuilding companies, they don't even give a cent.
そしてね、今度は海からどんどん酸素を出す。それから山は切らないようにすると。ね、日本では子供ができるときれいな着物着せてお宮参りに刺すんです。そんなことを要請中です、私は。そしてね、生まれたならば一本木植えと。それ誕生日なんてお祝いすることにならんと。ね、年々再々一本ずつ木を植えという、こういう運動をやるんです。
And I'm very active in the blue and green campaign, which is to increase the greenery in Japan and to promote a bluer sea. And in Japan, when a baby is born, they dress her or him up very nicely and go to the shrine. And I say, don't do that if you have the money to do that. Whenever a child is born, plant a tree. And this is one of the ways that I am hoping to help the environment.
で、人口を抑える。そうするとたくさんですね。はい、酸素を吸えて長生きできると。
こういったこと。それには、
リュウクさんのやっていらっしゃるですね、人口問題、これは大変な大事な、一番大事なことだと。
If we can control the population, we can have cleaner air for everyone. And in this respect, I think that what Mr. and Mrs. Duke are doing in relation to their population activities is something very, very important, and I fully support it.
ご先祖はこれを残された。これは万九変わらない財産です。同時にまた今やっていらっしゃる人口問題。これもね、もう世界の人間にとって一番大事なことです、これ。これまた残ります。
And what we see here, which has been handed down by the Duke family, this is something very impressive, but what they are doing now is also very, very impressive and will remain in history.会長、この辺でフィルムが切れたそ
うです。どうもありがとうございました。
Thank you very much.
Thank you very much.
We appreciate this. 誠におそ松様でございます。
ありがとう。会長、このマイクをお取りにならないと。
はいはい。